to say research has always been an interest. I don't know if it's something that I really thought that's the only thing I want to do. It was just definitely something that I was interested in and always I knew it was going to be part of my job.
Did you consider any other careers seriously before coming to medicine or research?
Well, I did pursue my marine biology, but I realized that a lot of the jobs were going to be sort of in the middle of nowhere, and trying to have sort of more of a, you know, family setting and you know be close to your loved ones, we're probably not going to be so, well, I'm not going to be able to do that with marine biology. I'm a pathologist and I help the COL with their orthopedic research projects. So right now I'm actually writing a paper that looks at acute management of ACL injuries. Well, with that paper, we're trying to see what would be the best treatment option for acute management of ACL injuries. So, you know, an athlete often, and especially female athletes, often have ACL injuries. And so the sort of typical treatment that they get, not depending, I mean, it doesn't even matter what grade of ACL tears they have, is that they'll go through some sort of non-surgical management of that. So right now, the sort of standard of care is looking at, you know, NSAIDs, so giving them a non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drug, as well as getting them to rest their knee, put ice on it, you know, elevate it. And so, you know, so right now what we're trying to see is is there other treatment options that would be better than that?
What drew you to this topic specifically? What about it interests you the most?
Well, I guess as we all are aging, you do definitely see that we're all, I mean, a lot of us are going to get osteoarthritis. So it's definitely something that I can relate to. Also, my mom just recently had a total hip replacement done. And so definitely what I've learned from working this lab has helped me kind of help her with, you know, the decisions she needs to make on her end and finding a good doctor. So yeah, definitely it's something that, you know, everyone can really relate to, because all in the end, either we're going to have a loved one or ourselves are going to be affected by it.
What would you say you're most proud of up to this point?
Well, I guess the journey. Because you never know what you're going to do. I mean, when you go to get your first degree, I mean, I never thought of going to veterinary medicine. So I think it's just, I'm just proud of like what I've accomplished, especially thinking that I was just going to get a bachelor degree and, you know, just go in the workforce and, you know, everyday kind of person. But no, I actually like, you know, did all these degrees and had a lot of experiences.
Bozynski suggests that you take advantage of the journey as well.
Definitely, you should keep your mind open to any possibilities. Try to be able to, you know, get some experience in a lab, you know, as like volunteer, like maybe just, you know, if there's some labs that you're interested in, go online, check them out, try to contact the people, try to do some volunteer work in the lab, you know, just to figure out what it's all about, because I think it's really definitely important.